Andreas Hauber.
We'll go around the room.
Hi, Tom, historical resident.
Chris Ryan, historical resident, for our land's body on this.
Robert Newman, street class, hi everybody.
For you guys, a street class, if you can help.
Sarah, just here to watch.
Then, go to meeting minutes. So look at the meeting minutes from May. And I'll move to approve the meeting minutes from next. All in favor? And, ready to go to the table?
So I think we need some time to set up, so, can you do the security update, Brittany?
Sure.
In your package, you have a copy of the security updates. It's gonna start looking a little bit different over the next couple months, and we're planning with our reporting system, seeing what features, what visuals look better in your package, and what is a better picture of what we're dealing with there. What we added recently was the heat map that shows where concentration of our efforts and most of our incidents are being generated from. And so the hotter the image looks, the more red it looks, the more incidents we're having at those locations. So you see a concentration around 7th and Broadway, and then mostly at intersections. 5th and Broadway, 6th and Broadway, 5th and Spring, 6th and Spring. And that's where you'll see that we're spending the majority of our time. It's not broken down into what types of incidents we're dealing with at this point, but eventually over time we want to see this picture get a little more clear and showing you what we're dealing with and where. And it's just a matter of trying to put it all on one paper, but still make it make sense. And then if you go down into the activity breakdown, there's a breakdown of all the activities. We're still keeping the same three classifications that we have, and we're still keeping those stats, but we're also showing you a picture of what's occurring. So rather than just saying, oh, we have vehicles, and we're telling you what kind of vehicle collisions, and we're providing assistance for you. And there's those potential changes. And most of these, they are for calls for service, flag downs. So you see like trespassing right there. Trespassing is mostly people going inside of businesses and businesses saying you need to leave, you're not a customer here, or you're probably not a service here, or whatever the reason you may be inviting customers in a bar, something like that. So we're just responding and we're providing uniform presence for you trespassing. And we're observing as a team, that's where that's kind of see. Any questions?
Really great to see you. We're 329 people that we've engaged, and as Brittany referenced with regard to the system, we're in the process of a different part of that system, putting the data that we've collected and the information. So I'll be reflected on your report in the future. And you know, we see a lot of new faces, as well as you guys are. We're out and about, so obviously we're being very fluid. How we're approaching things, we're still using the changes, stages of change model. It's very effective. And we'll just keep plugging away. As you see, I have my phone out around us because it's not only engaging the people, but calling on the phone right away to try to connect them with the services and whatever the needs are. So it's kind of a multitasking approach. But great to see everybody. And thank you for funding this part of the what we do here. How important it is and how much obviously we care about everybody that you're giving. So thank you very much.
Thanks for your hard work.
If you do see people, please reach out to me. Let me know that I can coordinate Bob if he's on to come by and interact with them. Sometimes it takes a few meetings before they can actually be positioned somewhere, but at least you can get started.
Is it Joel? Is it here?
restaurant. It's a Cuban restaurant.
Cuban restaurant, exactly. I also sat with the board of the streetcar, and they are moving forward. So Shane Phillips is no longer with them. There is no immediate replacement for him. So they're just kind of shuffling through all of the other responsibilities as needed. But they are moving towards private and public partnerships in order to be able to fulfill the last track funding that they need in the restaurant for the streetcar. Their ask for us for the board is if anyone is interested or knows of an investor who is interested, that they let us know.
This area, as you know, the historic core, we've got a little problem, especially the last 6 months. It's just the mentally ill and so forth. I mean, I've had a tenant knocked out of teeth, she's walking their dog, and another guy, the bakery basically left the door open, the side door. He went upstairs. Anyways, he got into the fire escape, it was pretty okay. He went to the ninth floor because apparently the other windows were locked. And the rabbi, for example, has pepper sprayed four people already this year. We've had some tenants, they move out because of, lately it's got a lot worse. We're all doing okay residential-wise. We're all pretty much full. But if it keeps on going like this, we'll get a bad historic call. I'm in the financial district. They had one really problem with the death of the Korean man. But we're really a different country here in the historic call. And it just keeps on going the way it is. We're going to get a bad name, and tenants won't want to patronize or rent. Like I say, right now it's okay. People go and come. As far as residential goes, but just generally speaking, it's just this past 6-8 months, it's just somehow, I don't know how, it's a very difficult situation. I don't know, we have to do something about it because it's really getting out of hand. I know you'll notice. Yeah, I have other stories too that I can't remember all of them, but that's about it.
I think we want to have
most likely have an executive committee meeting, so certainly the executive committee members can sort of come up with a way of voting for any of this that you want. I want you guys to feel like you have a ability to talk about it. And of course, anybody can attend that meeting as well. It doesn't have to be exclusive. So, please start the presentation.
Maybe you can make that even if you run a body camera.
You can make that easy as well.
I mean, you just said it needs to be focused, though.
No, I know. Yeah, I think it's
over.
Yeah, he's in. Okay, we want to go from here.
I'll just give a little brief background before architect that explains the project a little bit. This project came about a little over a year ago when we acquired the site. The idea behind the site was creating this new micro unit apartments where it seems like the demand in downtown is there, but the supply is none. It was a tight site right here on 4th, on Main between 4th and 5th Street. We have the Rosmite historic building next door. So part of the design of the project was again to go for this new micro unit, average size about 500 square feet, most likely furnished apartments that will be very affordable for new construction projects compared to some of the other stuff that's coming on the market. And at the same time, design something to match the aesthetic look of the historic Rosmite Hotel, and at the same time, do the same new modern concept. So.
Okay, thank you. The presentation really consists in two phases. The first one explains the project for the meeting with Simon Drummond. By the way, he's been your audience. This is Simon Neiman, part of the owners of the property. My name is Drummond Donari, I'm the Nari Associate of the Nari. So, I was saying that the presentation had been divided quickly in two segments, or two phases. The first one explained it to the project is about. The second one addressed some issues related to the access to the site and Main Street and the alley behind it. So we put it together in order to explain that it's a sequence of the presentation for the U.S. campus program. This is, you know, the building, as you probably already identified the site, is adjacent to the Roslyn Hotel, a Victoria building. And in our several conversations with the Victoria Commission, with the Victoria Consultant, we designed a building which is essentially pretty much in lieu and responding to the Victoria Complex. So we are keeping the same height. As you can see, we are accentuating on the facade of the building, some of the ornaments and some of the conditions contained in the Victoria building. But the major idea of this project is to create like a huge window to make. That big opening that you can see in the middle that is connecting with an internal courtyard, an armature with green, etc. becoming reality, the focus of the building. So the building moved inside, and everything else is pretty much a screen, and this is the back of the building, facing the alley. So both facades have been treated with the same level of quality, with the same level of finishing. It's not that we are saying it's in the back of the building, it's in the front of the building. Something very normally, not very common when you are dealing with a back alley. In the back alleys are treated almost like a sort of a secondary facade. In this case, are treated equally important. One of the reasons, and now you will see our next move, is connected with the idea what happened with the residents who are currently living on the island.
Before we go get there, just as you mentioned, as mainly downtown developers and investors, when we design projects, it's not 100% about the financial, full financial feasibility. So as you can see from the design, there's character, the front and the back that we added that definitely increased the cost. We might be kind of out of our way to make this look more beautiful to help improve the area a little more, especially the backside where there's a lot of condo owners. Behind from the Rowan and the Eldorado face that direction to make it look more a nicer view from the outside.
So even the downtown and Los Angeles in general is going towards a sort of cloud-based approach by reality. In reality still we need to comply with the parking regulations. So in order to avoid any overexposure of parking on the ground level. Today is a parking lot, which is a sort of a, you know, urban ground place, ground spot. We are putting up our parking only serving the residential, and I would say why, not the retail area, underground, which is almost another additional cost, I don't need to tell you that. Underground parking lights. Sincerely, really much more expensive than above ground floor. So when you are looking to the building, the reality what you see at least in the ground floor. On the right side is main, on the left side is the Harlem Alley. And what we try to do is to really make a connection in between the alley, and you will see subsequently another image of where we are trading. With Main. We are creating like an internal street through the building.
Some history behind that was when we, the alley, there's some residences that open up from the Rowan directly into the alley, and there's been some talks for years about vacating the alley, which has never happened. I mean, we need all the owners' consent to do it, but they want to kind of make it a little more street friendly. So when we presented the project to planning, we originally wanted to make our entrance from Main Street to the parking. And from the different departments and planning we went to, it was an absolute non-starter from their words. It's impossible to add a curb cut to Main Street. It's one of the highest traffic walking areas in all of downtown. So the logic behind them is, this is what alleys are made for. Why would you cut another curb cut on Main Street when there already is so much foot traffic, as opposed to put it in an alley where it's supposed to be, like the alleys are made for. So even originally our design, I don't know if Daniel can show up up there, the parking was towards the end, more down the alley, and there was no...
Yes. What was originally was on Main here, we moved it to the back of the alley.
Yeah. And there was no entrance from the alley that up there is a passage that goes through now, kind of like a street now, all the way in between the block from Spring to Main. So that's a walkway that goes from the park that will go through our project and come out to Main.
So there's a big block Paseo. My name is Daniel Abrams, co-development site with Simon. We established a pedestrian Paseo mid-block from Spring to Main that goes through the park, through the alley, and through our property out up to Main. And this is something that doesn't really exist in downtown, and it's going to be activated all the way through.
We try to come up with a compromise where it's somewhat of an alley vacation from a certain point, at the same time connecting the streets and allowing us to move forward with the project if the parking, the only feasible location, is in the back.
Another component associated with it, with the parking. We restricted the retail area of the ground floor to less than 7,500 square feet. And the reason why we did that, you know, I can tell you how attractive for a developer to have a large retail area is because if you create over 7,500 square feet, the zoning code requires parking. If you are under 7,500, you can eliminate the parking in that. And that was allowing us to make a space more pedestrian friendly, which is the whole story of the project. You know, let me in this one, what we call the alley of the circulation, is it very critical, very clear the way that the strategy, the design strategy is. On the red lines, you see the red circulation line, indicate the pedestrian circulation. You see it's coming from the park, going through the building, that will be open until midnight, so it will be several hours of operation. People will be able to transit, to move through the building, connecting the park, connecting Main, and going in front of the retail. There are two small retail spaces, so it would be almost like a little tiny shopping arcade. Pasadena, as you know, has a lot of examples like that associated with Main Avenue, which are very friendly, very nice to that. And then they used to be, but they are kind of a dying now. So this is the internal courtyard. The courtyard is what we call the green armature. It's a tremendous vertical tree where all the neighbors, all the residents, will be shared this common courtyard for a certain level of privacy through terraces, balconies. Is, I will call that is an inward project, but the outward portion is the big window that you saw before, that actually we are looking from the alley on the third floor towards the window. You see that light, that lit space is the view of the facade across the street. So it's a building integrated with the street. It's not denying the street. This is the whole concept of this project, which is not really very common in any residential project. So you can see there the sides of the courtyard.
The courtyard, so you see the sizes are very small. Again, that goes to the micro unit theme. And at the same time, we have three different open space areas. One in the courtyard, as you saw. One, I think it's on the 7th or 8th level.
Right there. This is the window to the ceiling. See, it's a big open space that connects directly to Main. That brown area, the seating area facing Main.
And then this is the 6th floor deck that has a little jacuzzi, community room, gym. And then it goes together. And this is a section that you can see kind of the building, 2.5 levels underground. Again, this is a picture to kind of see how we try to match the aesthetic look with the historic Roslyn Hotel. But at the same time, give it its own new modern look. And as far as one bedroom studio breakdowns, mostly studios, I'll say probably 50%, and then 45% one bedrooms, and then a few two bedrooms. Again, the main idea for this was to kind of fit the demand of a more affordable new construction, high amenity building with an average size of 500 square feet. I think someone presented it for maybe a little over $2,000 French, which I don't think you can find anywhere in downtown.
So how small is the unit?
They go anywhere, I think it's small, 350 square feet.
Yeah, 365.
The average size for all everything all put together is about 500.
Yes.
How many units do you have in the
back? 196 square
feet. And furnished, you said?
Our idea for right now is the furniture. So someone could come in ready to go. They'll probably put some kind of furniture that makes the space look bigger.
And is this a month?
The plan is to be longer term, 1 year, but I mean we're open again. Yeah.
So we got it.
So
it's new frame,
structure. Structure?
Yeah.
It's a type 5. No, I'm sorry, it's type 1. Type 1 and type 3. Depending on what we use. I mean, we have a concrete podium, and then we have a light structure on top. Tennis store, exactly the same height of the Roslyn Hotel.
This kind of shows you where it says parking lot is where our site is. The park is right behind it. So you would see our paseo would kind of let you walk through the park, cross over the alley, which at some portion will be cut off, so it'll be vacated, and walk through where it says parking lot will be our project will come out.
Let me explain you something. This is what I call the second phase of the project. These images that you will see now are the outcome of several meetings that we maintain with the community members, with the city council office, with the planning department, So, kind of reacting, responding, and addressing some of those concerns, we came up with this design for the alley. And let me tell you how it's possible to do it. Investigating with the city of LA, with the Department of Transportation and Public Works, we found out that it's a description of a street called Shared Street. The Shared Street allows to reduce the width of a regular street or an alley up to 17 feet. In the moment that you reduce it to 17 feet as a roadway, allow us to allocate 3 feet freer for pedestrian circulation. So that design that you see here is in the view of the alley that we created with David Shaw. So you are walking along the alley like on a European street. You know, my family is Italian, so that's the way that I grew up.
Oh, yeah.
And those,
where did they from?
Florida. Yeah. And those little asphyxiated narrow streets that everybody hates but everybody loves. Okay? So we are trying to kind of present that kind of idea for this alley in downtown. And then people, the left side, I'm sorry, go back because it's important, the left side of that image is actually the residence. That's where the existing condominiums are. So by doing that, we allow them, which is kind of a weird condition, to swing the doors to the outside, currently directly to the alley, without being interrupted or affected by the traffic. This is what we are proposing for the site. So that will be paid by the developer.
So this alley has a potential future of multiple uses, and we're trying to be sensitive to that future, which could entail a vacation of sort where it could be more pedestrianized, where the backs of these buildings could be activated with retail and have more amenity to the community. Now, in order to find a happy medium between vehicular access, loading, service, which is all going to be involved in that alley, even when it is vacated in the future, there's going to be that roadway, essentially, that Roberto described, that goes into our parking garage, which is at the southernmost point of our parcel here, and a segmented pedestrian sidewalk along the Rowan. Then, about 40 to 50% through our property, there's going to be a fence of sort or bollards that are removable that will essentially have a purely pedestrian experience north of our property, actually about halfway to our property, to Fifth Street. Which obviously for fire or emergency, those bollards move away and there's going to be access as far as trash removal from Gilmore's buildings. But it's going to be primarily pedestrian experience from about halfway through our property north. That's the ultimate goal to achieve at some point in the future. Obviously with any type of project of this sort, to do this with a public alley, you need all the owners to sign off. So we're working toward a comprehensive agreement. This is something that will likely happen at some point in the future. And to be sensitive to that, we're designing our project hopeful that that will actually happen by putting that pedestrian paseo through our property to the alley and also designing this to accommodate that future vacation. We've also proposed that half of our TFAR money go toward beautification of the alley and to help actually make this a reality.
So kind of going around what he said, why we're here. The project is submitted by right. We're not going asking for any incentives other than the TFAR that's less than 50,000, which needs the discretionary public hearing by city council. So far, planning, most departments I met with love the project. They think downtown needs it. From comments in the public, they love the design, they love the idea, they love the fact that there's going to be affordable new construction apartment units coming to the market. We've met with planning, we're getting ready to finish the environmental, and we've already gotten approval from Neighbor Council, so the next step is hopefully to gain your support.
And also to hear any feedback that you may have for us.
Sorry, it's
more
than fourth, you said that you need
fourth street?
Fourth street. Yeah, sorry.
And in terms of the other properties, there's a consensus that the planning is
well, Tom Gilmore owns nearly most of the, actually he owns all the buildings except the El Dorado, north of our property. So he is in control of what happens north of that. There's, you know, fortunately few stakeholders. There's Arts, there's Gilmore, there's the Rowan and El Dorado, you know, homeowner association.
Absolutely.
And the Ross, yeah, right.
Planning has made it clear to everyone that there's no way they're going to allow for Main Street.
Right. You know, with the Vision Zero project from the councilman's office, they're putting in new bike lanes, pedestrian access, all on Main and Spring, that they're actually starting very soon. So they're looking to remove as many north-south curb cuts as possible all over the city of Los Angeles.
And in terms of coexisting pedestrians and traffic cars, that's allowable without any separation? Or?
Well, this is an alley. And any alley in downtown, there's cars, there's people, there's loading, there's garbage, there's service. And these are meant to service all of our buildings. It just so happens there are some alleys in downtown that lend themselves to more of a pedestrian experience as well, to activate them. And this happens to be one of them. So we're trying to create, as best we can, an environment where it can be activated and the service vehicles and access to other cars can also still be provided. And that's why we created not just aesthetically materials, but different elevations and different protective and measures such as speed bumps, and we'll put the ballards here as well. But this is the sidewalk on the Roland side, and this is a driveway here that just goes straight to our garage and it ends there.
I wasn't here, so what you're asking is to privatize the alley.
So to privatize this, it's not to privatize it, it's going to be a vacation of the alley that still has access to vehicles, service vehicles, fire and safety. What's that?
No gates.
No gates. On the south side, there will be gates on the north side. But this is something that's been in works for years. And it's, in my opinion, not even close to being done. There's a lot of people involved. But the end game, the goal, is to have a pedestrian-friendly, activated alley with, you know, restaurants on the alley and seating.
Isn't that the same alley that Tom Gilmore is walking through?
This is that alley. That's it. Yeah,
that's yes, it. That's Tom.
Yeah.
I thought it was
vacated. It's not vacated. It's not vacated by any means.
Really?
No. The gates that are up right now were put up with a short-term permit, a 90-day permit, and they went up, and then, yeah, 20 years ago, and then they just never came down. They've been there ever since.
And there are cars going in and out there right now. It's just there is a gate there, and even Gilmore's parking lot in the middle of the block.
Right.
Access that would be interesting.
So you can enter, actually, to get to Gilmore's garage, Bankhouse Garage, you can access from Spring Street to that little alley, and it drives through Spring into the back of his garage. So
what are you guys asking? Is it Tom doing that?
Well, actually, we're just sharing the project with you right now. We're not asking for anything from you now, other than just sharing with you what the current status quo is. Yes, of course, support it ultimately.
And you guys are building what, 50 units now?
196 units.
196 and 50,000 square feet.
And on what?
We are under 50,000 square feet for the T-bar.
Right.
For the transfer of the No. The overall project is 120,000.
So you got 190 units. Is that affordable housing? Or?
No, it's not affordable housing. Our concept is, well, what drove this project is downtown right now is developing a lot of high-end housing, luxury housing that costs $3,000, $4,000, $5,000, $6,000, $7,000 a month plus. We're doing micro units, average size of 500 square feet, and
with a lot of amenities.
With fully amenitized building.
You've got, super.
Yeah, fully amenitized. And because of the size of the units, we're able to provide, you know, a low all-in rate on monthly rents.
Can you show the facade again if you don't mind?
Sure. Simon.
Simon.
Can you put up the facade, please?
The front or the back?
The front.
Obviously, you did your research. I mean, it's three small units. I mean, like, I mean, obviously, you're pretty confident. I mean,
we are because
you're doing it.
Right.
Yeah, the facade. How was it with Lambert? Did you get pretty much what you wanted, or you had to bend a bit, or?
Well, actually, we were very sensitive to the historic core, and we pretty much took full direction. Our building is actually set back about 5 feet just to accommodate a cornice that's at the top of the Rothman building. It wraps around on the side, and for our building, which is, you know, at the property line, they didn't want to cut that cornice off or damage it, so we literally set back our entire building 5 feet because of that piece. So, and also they wanted us to follow the lines of the Roslyn, which you can see, we followed the lines with a modern concept, following those historic lines. So,
the facade with that large screen that you see is intended to be kind of a neutral facade, sort of like a backdrop, instead of competing with proportions and movement with the historic building. So the idea is to make it as, you know, low-key, simple, straightforward facade, and that's what we are creating, except that big opening, you know, which is not the really the connection with the scene. But that's the way that we have been treating the building. The lower level, the city historic director, insists that we agree that we need to show that sort of a continuation of the pyramid, which is that second level line, repeating the same story and the cornice right on the top. So you see our building is totally contained. And then on the bottom, we as well creating that sense of arcade that we have. You know, I am a contemporary designer, so even though my family is nothing better for Florence, I feel that I need to deal with the modern vocabulary. So how you relate with an old building, or supposedly an old building, not our own, in terms of philosophy. But I will try to really make a very strong movement to respect that context. And I think it has to be really
strong. Okay, are there any questions about the project?
Just the parking spaces.
We have 167 parking spaces.
Beautiful. It sounds like a wonderful project. I think it will be a great addition to the neighborhood. And I'd like to move to draft a lot of support.
Just curious, nothing. Is there balconies or what would those full balconies upstairs?
There are balconies. Not all units, but some. Okay, yeah.
Did you put a motion?
Just one second.
All in favor?
Okay.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Flyers, people can just
know, simple.
Tips.
LAPD.